you are not searching on Google correctly. Well, probably. If you're a college student, it's likely you have already used Google to find the source that you were looking for an essay. Like, normally, you will just come in and find, hey, I'm looking for this source, press enter, and then probably stick with the first results. But there are many Google search operators you can use to find exactly what you're looking for. At least in my essay writing process, searching for sources is one of the most critical parts, arguably the most important one. I can even spend up to 2 or 3 hours looking for that specific source that will help the essay that I want to write and that suits the outline I have in mind. So it's important that you do the same, especially if you want to continue having A's. So in this Gradehacker tutorial, I'm going to show you the 7 Google search operators you need to start using now. Still, a tiny disclaimer, you're going to see that most of these operators work better when you mix them. It's not like you can only use one. I mean, you can do it, but it's not going to be as efficient as using at least 2 or 3 of them. So have that in mind, but let's start with number 1, quotation marks. We can use this to find exact keywords that we need. For example, let's say we want to write something about air pollution, maybe in a state like Ohio. We find, and here we find, of course, this is what you would normally see even if you are not using the quotation marks, but again, you'll see how eventually all will make sense. The second one is the operator site. This one, you can use it to ask Google to find results only within the website you want. So for example, if we are looking for a credible source to use in our essay, we can use NCBI. So we just write site, we paste the link, and now we will only find results that match air pollution and are within NCBI. Amazing. And if you're looking for something that was posted between a specific time range, you can use before and after. So for example, here we want results on air pollution in Ohio that were posted before, let's say, 2010. So now Google is going to give us results that were published before the year we gave it. This is a great example. This one was posted in 1996. But let's say we don't want to go that far in time, so we can now go, we type in after, and we ask it to be, okay, between 2000 and 2010. And now all results are going to be between that time range. Now, what happens when you want to look for something but don't want to come across a specific keyword or subject? You just go ahead and use the minus sign. For example, let's say we want to look for information about Oppenheimer, but as you see, the first results are going to be about the latest movie from Christopher Nolan. Amazing movie. Like the trailer, IMDb information, Rotten Tomatoes, and that's not what we're looking for. Of course, we can also go ahead and see results about J. Robert Oppenheimer, but we can also, for example, come here and minus Nolan. And we'll see that most of the results that we'll find, if not all, are going to be related to J. Robert Oppenheimer. And now one of my personal favorites, file type. With this, you can ask Google to only give you results that are in the format that you're looking for. In most of the college student cases, PDF. So again, if we are looking for air pollution in Ohio, we add file type PDF, and now all the results are going to be, if not PDF, are going to include some kind of it. It's simply one of the best tips that college students should be using. But when you want to look for 2 different keywords or concepts at the same time, you can use OR. And yes, it needs to be in capital letters. So let's say you are looking for basic information on countries like Spain or Canada, and then Google is going to give you the basics that you can find on Canada, on Spain, with related news and everything that has to do with these 2 countries. And for last, we save the wild card, the asterisk. Why? Because it basically matches any keyword that you are not including in the search bar. For instance, let's say we want to write this amazing book that we read when we were younger, but we don't remember exactly what was the name. We remember it was The Chronicles, that it was from sci-fi. So we go here, we write The Chronicles we say was sci-fi and it's a book. First, we have this result, which is not exactly what we're looking for, but now we found it. It was Martian Chronicles by Ray Bradbury. What a book. As I said first, these operators work better when you mix them. I mean, I have already mixed a few of them in the examples I gave before. Let's take a closer look at this more specific example that we are looking for air pollution in Louisiana, and we don't want to hear anything about wildfire smoke, and it has to be something that was posted after 2021 and needs to be only posted by the NCBI. So we have this, we press enter, and here these results are going to be exactly what we're looking for. So example number one, past. Let's get to example number two. Similarly, we want something that's about Oppenheimer, ethics, does not talk about Christopher Nolan, and was posted after 2020, and has to be a PDF. So now Google is giving us results that match the search filters that we added. But once again, you can use these search operators however you like. You can mix them, you can use 1, 2, 3, I recommend 3 for really accurate results. But still, just go around and play with it until you find. And if you use them and you see this is not what I was looking for, you can try in different ways. After all, we all have years of using Google, so we know that there is more than one way to get to one result. But with these tips, you'll see how easy it is to find the accurate results that you were looking for. Hey, let us know in the comments if you have any tips on how to use Google. And make sure to subscribe to our channel where you'll find plenty of tips for your college life. For example, this tutorial on how to use ChatGPT to write an essay. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.